Greetings. The next example of a logical problem for Islam is the following claim. The Quran claims it is clear, but also admits it is not clear. Surah 11:1, Alif Lam Ra, a book, the signs in it were set clear. Again, they were explained distinctly from that which proceeds from the presence of the wise, aware. The signs in it, or message, were set clear. Here we see assertion of distinct explanations. Surah 1689, and the day we send to every nation a witness against them from themselves, and we have brought you as a witness against these, meaning the Arabs, and we have sent down to you the scripture as a clarification for all things, and a guide in mercy and good tidings to those who have surrendered. The Quran is declared to be a clarification for all things, a book whereof the verses are explained in detail, a Quran in Arabic for people who know, Surah 41:3. This ayat claims the verses are explained in detail. There you have it in a nutshell. The Quran is clear. If you take the Quran at its word, it explains all things in detail. But then the Quran contradicts itself and hedges its claim. When the Quran also admits, parts of it are not quite so clear. Surah 3:7, it is He who sent down the book to you from Him. Ayats containing clear judgments, they are the core of the book. This speaks to the concept some verses are absolutely clear. As we shall see, this means no room for interpretation. The ayat continues, and others which are open to interpretation. If some are open to interpretation, the others are not. This phrase is also rendered as the following. So the Bewley translation says, and others which are open to interpretation, as well as others that are allegorical, and others which are allegorical, note the parentheses, ones that are unspecific, that's the Bakhtiar translation, while others are allegorical is another, and others which are similar to each other, that's the monotheist group translation, and others co-similar or ambiguous. Now perhaps you've noticed that even the experts cannot tell what this phrase means. Some choose the word allegorical. Allegories, like parables, use stories or figures to represent abstract concepts. That is a valid literary construct and seems like a reasonable expectation. Thus, you are given two choices, clear ayat or conceptual stories. Other translations refuse to use claims of allegory to mask lack of clarity. These support the logical reading that parts are unclear, ambiguous, or open to interpretation, unspecific. I see no logical basis to inject claims of similar to each other or co-similar. I don't even know what that means. Unless this indicates just how dubious the Arabic actually is. And that is a problem for anyone wishing to claim they know what the Quran means. Without doubt, one may mimic and utter the syllables of the ancient Arabic as new consignees do when they are required to say Shahada in Arabic. But the Quran contradicts itself by claiming both clarity with details for all things, while simultaneously admitting it contains verses ambiguous and open to interpretation. The immediate problem is knowing which is which. Certainly, the Bible has allegories and metaphors. Jesus taught in parables. and the Bible sometimes labels them with, "And he," Jesus, "began teaching them many things in parables, and in his teaching he was saying to them, listen to this, behold, the sower went out to sow." After teaching in Mark 10, as soon as Jesus was alone with the 12 and those around him, they asked him about the parable. And then in verse 13, "Then Jesus said to them, don't you understand this parable? How then will you understand any parable?" Evidently, this one was pretty obvious. This is just one example of how the Word of God records complete, coherent teachings. Jesus taught the parable, and the parable is recorded. The disciples asked Jesus to explain it to them. Jesus explained it to them, and they recorded the explanation. Even hidden in parables, the Word of God completely explains the meaning. This is just one of dozens of examples. To be fair, the book of Revelation is symbolic and is not yet fully revealed. But the nature of the vision makes that abundantly clear. Nor does the Bible attempt repeatedly to establish its legitimacy with claims of clarity and detail, as does Muhammad's Quran. The Quran also creates between 2 and 4 different ambiguous scenarios. The ayat are clear. The ayat are allegorical. The ayat are open to interpretation. Or the ayat are ambiguous. I think the first 2 are the more commonly claimed. Even with 2, the Quran does not give any clear indication which is which. And to me, that constitutes a logical problem. Let me give you 2 clear examples of confused contents in the Quran. The first example is the random characters, known as Alif Lam Mim. Many surah in the Quran begin with random Arabic letters. Surah 2, Alif Lam Mim, and Surah 3. Surah 7, Alif Lam Mim Sad. And then Surah 10, 11, and 12 begin Alif Lam Ra. The letters do not mean anything. They do not form actual words. Because they are not words, they do not have a clear meaning. Nor can they possibly present any allegorical information or symbology. They are literally incoherent and meaningless gibberish, as might be the typing of a baby or a monkey on a keyboard. And Islam is faced with a sad situation. They must invent a reason for these random characters. Rather than label them as gibberish, Islam, with a shrug, declares, "Allah only knows." But this flies in the face of claiming the Quran is clear, explained in detail. In this video, I am not going to explore and leverage the plausible explanation of the Jewish scribe who was compelled to scribe the Quran for Muhammad, who created these characters. If someone can confirm through expert knowledge of Hebrew that these random characters do in fact form valid Hebrew, please comment below. The second example demonstrates the absolute confusion offered due to the lack of coherent details. This particular example is one of the most controversial claims by Muhammad. Surah 4, 157, Part A. "And because of their saying, we slew the Messiah, Jesus son of Mary, Allah's messenger, they slew him not, nor crucified him, but it appeared so unto them." This is only the first half of the ayat, but nothing that follows clarifies this portion. Now, this seems like a clear statement, correct? At this point, I am not challenging the factuality of the claim, only the clarity. Is this verse clear in what it attempts to say? but let us not cherry-pick a single example. The Irving translation, "And also for their saying, we killed God's messenger, Jesus Christ, the Son of Mary, they neither killed nor crucified him, even though it seemed so to them." The Bewley translation, "And their saying, we killed the Messiah, Issa, son of Maryam, messenger of Allah, they did not kill him, and they did not crucify him, but it was made to seem so to them." The Taki Usmani translation, "And for their saying, we have certainly killed the Messiah, Issa, the son of Maryam, the messenger of Allah, while in fact they did neither kill him nor crucify him, but they were deluded by resemblance." The Munshe, "But they did not kill him, and they did not crucify him, it just appeared to them to be so." The Tahir ul Qadri, "Whereas they neither killed nor crucified him, but someone was made the like of Issa in their view." From the simple obvious reading of the verse, it appears to state that Jesus was not killed by the Jews. "They slew him not." Other translations say "killed him not." And additionally, "Jesus was not even nailed to the cross, nor crucified him." But for this to be clear, it should contain details that make sense. If Jesus was not killed and was not even crucified, what happened? And this is where Islam is plagued by a lack of logical detail in the clear Quran. In fact, some translators try to fix the Quran, inventing the details for it. The Bakhtiar, "Rather a likeness of him," him meaning Jesus, "of another was shown to them." So a likeness to him of another was shown to them. Somebody else who looked like Jesus. "Whereas they neither killed nor crucified him, but someone was made the like of Jesus in their view." Here another person was made to look like Jesus to them. The Muhammad Sarwar, "They in fact murdered someone else by mistake." These three translations incorporate aspects of the six inventions I have encountered to invent sufficient details to attempt to logically defend Surah 4:157. Remember, the Quran claims ayat are either clear with all details needed or they are allegorical. Obviously, this ayat is incomplete and has insufficient detail to present a meaningful account or story. But then do Muslims really want to try and defend this ayat as allegorical? Beyond that serious logical failure of this oh-so-important ayat, whichever invention you hear to support Surah 4:157, they all struggle to support a willful act of deception. An action whereby Allah lies to all the Muslim followers of Jesus. Logically, if Allah is such a liar, nothing he has revealed may be trusted. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to his Son, the crucified Lord Jesus Christ, whom God raised from the dead. Amen.